With over 20 million Beetles sold since its launch, you'd think I'd be able to find a decent one in the country somewhere, wouldn't you? Well, I had a word with a guy who lives in Hampshire, and he says he's got a classic example hidden in a barn, and I love those barn finds. Well, guess what? This is it. And what a complete waste of my time. This car is a scrapper. It's not fit for anything other than the dustbin. Do you know, I'm going to find the fella who said this is a classic, and I'm going to make him explain himself. Peter, I'm not being funny, mate. This is beyond a joke. You said it was a classic on the phone. The bumpers are gone, no headlamps, the wheels are shot, no running boards, the wheel arches are gone through. I haven't even got round the other side yet. Where is there a classic in this?
Oh, the Beetle is a classic car. All these parts are just cosmetic. They're easy replaceable.
Cosmetic my bum. That's going to cost an absolute fortune to put right. You said it was a nice, tiny example on the phone. I should ask you for my petrol money back. I think you've wasted my day.
I assure you, underneath it is really, really solid.
Underneath it may be a solid car, but I still... It's never going to go, though, is it?
Of course it will. I drove it in it.
When was that? 1985? 200 quid, cash... And that's it. Whether you want to take it or not, it's up to you. I'm not bothered either way, because I think he's wrong.
Well, tell you what then, you own it.
Do I? Oh dear. I wish I didn't. Come on, let's do the paperwork. Ed!
Hello,
how are you? I don't even want to shake your hand, fella.
Come on.
What a waste of money, Ed. Your face speaks a thousand words.
Did you drive it here?
Did I drive it? Does it look like I drove it here, Ed?
The engine works and everything.
Listen, I got a reputation to uphold. I couldn't be seen dead in a shed like this. Ed, I'm not being funny, mate, but you said, oh, don't worry, you get wings for a tenner.
Wings are cheap.
Buy a bumper for 15
Bumpers
quid.
Are cheap, yeah, yeah. But you also but said mate, that the running boards are, you know, are missing. That's fair enough. But what about the seals? The seals are completely knackered.
It was up to ear in straw. How can I... don't know anything about stuff like this. I just see cars for what they are. Look at the interior, fella. I mean... The amount of work you're going to have to do,
it's finished. It's a little tardy, obviously. It's a little tardy.
It's just a mess. I reckon that all we've done is thrown 200 quid into a bonfire.
Now hang on.
You see that building? See that building? That building's in better nick than this car.
You said this engine runs, right?
Well, yeah, I mean, like a lawnmower.
Yeah, right. Does it steer?
Well, I don't know. Yeah, I suppose so.
Well, hang on. Don't, just calm down a little
You're
bit.
You're not going to turn it around, Ed,
yeah,
are you?
Yeah, we are going to turn it around. This is what I do. Hang on. See... That floor pan is pretty sound, right?
Yeah.
So, and this year happens to be the 40th anniversary of the beach buggy.
So?
So we'll turn this into a beach buggy. I'm serious, this is the best bit about Beetles, of everything unbolts. So we unbolt all the rubbish we don't want, throw it away, nice floor pan, engine, steering.
Mate, there's a lot of grease and oil fudging around up there. Mate, if you unbolt the body from this, you're going to be left behind with a rusting chassis with four wheels bolted to it.
It's in good nick. Okay, we might need some new nice wheels, obviously, and do the engine up a little bit. Body, seats, interior, steering wheel, perhaps nice pod lights, it'll be there, it'll be fine. It'll be great.
Mate, I'd say you're having a laugh. We've invested, what, a couple of hundred quid in this pile of junk already?
Sure.
And you're talking, what, a shed load more money to turn it into a beach buggy? What's the point?
It'll be worth about £2,500 when it's done. Think of the summer, we're driving on the beach, Bermuda shorts, nice loud Hawaiian shirt, wind in the hair, it'll be fantastic fun.
Listen, I like the Bermuda shorts, yeah. I'm dying to get them out, and I like the loud shirts, and I like the wind in the hair thing, but Ed, come
have
on.
Have faith.
The
look,
amount of work you're going to
have miracles I pulled off before, you know I can do it, so let's just do this one more time.
Yeah, but Ed, we haven't got months. We've got, you know...
A week. Give us a week.
A week?
Easy.
Well, you can turn this into a beach buggy in a week.
That's right. You're having these things.
Mate, you're having a laugh.
No, seriously.
Honestly, if he can turn that into a beach buggy, I'm going to stop calling him Ed Wiener. I promise.
If this was a new car, it would be rather easy to separate the bodywork from the floor pan. There's just a row of bolts on either side of the bodywork. Unfortunately, this thing's about 4 million years old and everything's very rusty, so chances are the bolts may give me a whole load of grief. We'll have to see.
14 bolts attach the body to the floor pan, and with a bit of loosening agent, most of them come out just using an air gun, which is good, as grinding off each one would take ages.
I think I was pretty lucky there, only two bolts wouldn't come out. One here and one over there. But I'm going to sort them out with this.
Once my angle grinder gets in there, the body gives way with no resistance at all.
I've undone a load of bolts, I've disconnected everything, and if I could just take you back to when I removed the rear side windows, I've got a cunning plan. I'm going to take the arms of the ramp, stick them through the holes, and actually lift the body off the floor pan. Pretty clever, huh? Only thing is, did I take out all the bolts?
And off it comes. What a perfect, magical moment. It's out with the old and in with the new. Lovely. One chassis.
And there you have it, a Volkswagen skateboard. You've got wheels at the front, floor pan in the middle, and an engine at the end. Now, I've got plenty of work to be doing on this floor pan, so to make my life easier, I'm going to drop off the engine. Dropping an engine out of one of these things is really easy. There's only four bolts, a couple of cables, and a couple of wires. And even easier on this one, this bolt's missing.
This is the bit where I tell you to be methodical and store all the nuts in a safe place. But that's it. Otherwise, it's dead easy.
Rather than have the engine drop onto the floor, I'm going to use the trolley jack to support its weight. And that's how easy it is to remove a Beetle engine. This is the engine from our Beetle, and as is pretty obvious, it's seen better days. But I'm convinced that deep down there in the heart of it is an engine that is sweet and waiting to come out.
A bit of penetrating fluid, some elbow grease, and the nuts and bolts start to come apart.
Hey!
These bits are bulletproof. All they really need is a wash and brush up. Okay, so they need grinding down as well, but you get my point. Don't be scared to get stuck in. A quick splash of primer, some satin black, and these casings are transformed.
Our coating's painted and ready to go back onto the engine, but while it's this accessible, there really is something else I must do. A bit later on, we're going to change these horrible rusty rocker covers for these lovely shiny chrome ones. But underneath the rocker covers, surprisingly, is the rockers. There you have them, there's four rockers, some tappets, and the valves. So the tappets attach to the valves, and the valves bounce around when the engine is running. But there's a gap, you can hear it, between the rocker and the tappet. And for absolute perfect running of the engine, that gap has to be a critical dimension. And you measure that dimension with one of these, which is a feeler gauge. Now, the way to use this is to set the engine into the right position. So you rotate the crankshaft until both these valves are shut. And you can normally tell that, because there should be a little bit of slack. You then get your feeler gauge and stuff it in between the rocker and the tappet. Drag it around a bit, and you should be able to feel a light drag on the metal. It's actually quite loose, that one. I'll try the other one. And that's even worse. Now, that's a bad thing, because if it's too loose, then the rockers are slapping around, making loads of noise, but also lots of damage to the engine. And worse still, the valves basically won't be open for long enough, and that means bad performance. On the other hand, if it's too tight, then basically the valves barely ever shut, and that also means bad performance. So it's critical that this measurement is spot on. Adjusting these is actually quite an easy job. First of all, I crack off the lock nut, and then I adjust the screw until I've got a nice amount of drag with my feeler gauge. Just a bit more. There you go, just right. So now I'll just do up the lock nut again. And what I'll do is I'll keep the screwdriver in the screw at the same time, make sure it doesn't move. I'll do it up. Okay, and just check it one more time just to be sure. Perfect. All I have to do now is the other three cylinders.
There's loads more to do on this engine. Plenty of dressing and shiny things to go on. But that's enough oily stuff for now, because I'm expecting a visit from Mr. Brewer, and I'm not too sure what his reaction's going to be.
Click here to subscribe.